Okay, good evening, everybody. Okay. We are formally introducing, or I am technically formally introducing the English phonology and morphology. Okay, as it may appear in your subject description, it tackles about how language should be utilized effectively and how language should be used efficiently. It also has been the case, no, for English language majors to be very specific in how they pronounce words, okay, and how they learn how to pronounce words. But in this course, we have four periods, di ba? A prelim, midterm, pre-fi, and final. I decided to separate the topics, the phonology for the prelim and midterm, and sa atong pre-fi and final, diha na ta mag morphology, okay? Because medyo hangak siya nga topic. Sorry, medyo hangak siya nga topic. That's why I placed the morphology sa last, okay? But talking about the very thing, we need first to understand these two. Versus phonology. But before we formally start, I'd like to ask everybody if there are other prerequisite subjects that you have went through in your lower year nga nag-hisgot pud about language. For example, the English 101. Tapos na mo, ana? Specifically described as, or described as, the history of the English language, di ba? Insane yung instructor, ana? Ma'am Ruby. Okay. So, basically what that is that you were introduced about the origin of language, no? About the origin of how language was formed throughout history and what other development that the English language, no, has to take before the English language is called of what it is today. No? Sa atong topic this evening, I will specifically talk about phonetics and phonology. Because in language, as you are expected to be the masters, no, not necessarily the technical and literal definition of the masters of something, but I want you to be experts in your fields, such as the English language. That is why you are enrolled here, okay? So that you can be aware of the things and the do's and the don'ts about language, and specifically the pronunciation, because in the preliminaries, we will be talking about phonetics, which basically deals with the language pronunciation, no? And word pronunciation, and how words are being pronounced specifically, and how it is articulated and placed in our mouth or vocal apparatus, so to say. This is exactly the module 1, okay? The introduction to English phonetics and phonology, and that is why I tried to discern the differences between the two, and I will try to make you also understand. And by the grace of this discussion, no, I also expect, but at the end of the lesson, that you can differentiate, and at the end of this module, and hopefully at the end of this semester, you can differentiate the basic and most fundamental senses of the two. Okay, so introduction to English phonetics and phonology. This is also the lesson 1. Introduction to phonetics and phonology. It is defined here in our book, no? Our source says that phonetics and phonology, obviously, are essential branches of linguistics. Okay? These are the branches of linguistics that deal with sa pronunciation and how sounds are produced and how words should be pronounced. Okay? That focus on the study of speech sounds, as I said, and their patterns within a language. Understanding the principles of phonetics and phonology is crucial for achieving accurate pronunciation because, again, that is required for you as an English language major. No, same goes with the English major's education. No, pronouncing the word correctly matters, and pronouncing the word efficiently or the words efficiently matter, especially when communicating, because I guess it really gives a good impression. That's the bonus. And it also gives correct understanding and provokes good understanding sa language natong ipangsulti. Okay? Especially sa English language. Now, sa English language, mong good, we have these considerations on how to efficiently articulate and utter a single sound or a group of words. No? That's why in lesson 1, we will specifically break down the phonetics. Okay? The phonetics, like, let me, The phonetics is defined technically as the branch of linguistics that examines the production, transmission, and perception of speech sounds in human language. Basically, what I am speaking right now is the English language. I am using and utilizing the English language, no? How I am pronouncing each word and each letter deals with phonetics. Okay? It deals with phonetics in the sense that whatever it is that's going on within my mouth as I pronounce these letters, the inyong nabatian karon, no? Maunay branch sa phonetics. It deals with, again, take note, how words are articulated. Again, phonetics deals with how words are articulated. Meaning to say, how words are pronounced and what are the processes, because it deals with the how question, no? So basically, it deals with the processes involved in producing the sounds or the phonemes, no? And it deals also how the branches of phonetics are relevant to one another. Okay? Now, another definition is that phonetics investigates the physical properties of sounds. Okay? Including their articulation, as I said, acoustic properties, and auditory perception. Now, there are three branches of phonetics. The articulatory phonetics, which I just pronounced and uttered frequently, no? Deals with how words, again, are articulated. The articulatory branch, okay, says that specifically. And the notes that you just jot down, no? Dapat mabilong to siya dire sa articulatory phonetics because it deals with, again, how sounds are produced. Okay? The way that I pronounce the letter T, no? When I say the word talk, no? The sounds there, how the sounds are produced, deal with the articulatory branch of phonetics. Another thing is the acoustic phonetics. The acoustic phonetics, asa naman to? Wait sa ha? Deals with the physical property. Again, we're talking about the acoustic phonetics. deals with the physical properties of speech travel through air. Okay? It deals with the speech travel through air. And the difference here is this. Okay? Paminaw. When we say articulatory, again, yun sa pag-place sa imong dila, anong na-pronounce man ka o letter T. Okay? The explanation there, naka-pronounce ng letter or sound nga T sa letter T, no? Nga letter. It's because my tongue is placed on a certain area in my mouth, no? That's why it pronounce a certain sound. Koha. Okay? That's why it produced a certain sound, nga letter T and letter K, for example. It's because of the placement or the manner of how I speak. Okay? It deals with the vocal apparatus. Take note. It deals with the vocal apparatus. And the vocal characteristics and placement of the mouth. Okay? For example, no? There are those people nga dili makalitog og S. Coco Martin, for example, let's have that person. No? Ang iyang S is mahimog. It's not exactly the T sound, no? Ang S mahimo siyag or F sound, the way that you pronounce that, no? Or TH ba, mahimo siyag TH if you combine, no? The S there, or the people nga ingana, or mga ngujit gani, is called as lisp, okay? Lisp ang tawag anang mga tawang, kanang dili kalitokog S. It's because of the incorrect placement of their tongue, no? That's why naiba ang pronunciation, or the pronunciation has changed to another sound. For example, letter S dapat na, but it's because of the incorrect placement of the tongue, nahimo siyang TH, no? It's maybe there is a problem, or natuyo yun, or naanad lang yun siya sa pag-pronounce a certain sound that way. Okay? Now, class, if you try to understand, it's very hard in the beginning. It's very hard in the beginning, it's very difficult in the beginning, but as we go on, we will actually understand. Okay? We will follow the step-by-step process. And again, articulatory phonetics deals with how, the process. And the acoustic phonetics deals with the physical properties of the sound. Unsa mang yun ang characteristic ni letter S. Okay? Why S should be pronounced as S, no? And why the letter T is pronounced as T. And what are the considerations and the technicalities including the pronunciation and the vocalization of such sounds. Ingana siya. Okay? And the last part or last branch is the auditory phonetics. It deals with how one person receives the sound. No? From the word itself, auditory. Aminaw, from the word itself, auditory, na siya gitawag nga receptive part of the language, no? Such as the auditory phonetics. Okay? It's technically defined as how one received the speech. Again, how one person received the speech. Take note, mao lang na ang timan-an ninyo sa auditory phonetics. Sa acoustic, the physical properties of the sound. Or nganong ang letter K pronounced mong yud as letter K or K, K, K. Is letter K bag yud? Same sa letter C? Because again, most of the time, this is pronounced the same, di ba? The sounds are the same and you will learn that through the acoustic phonetics or the part of acoustic phonetics that deals with the physical properties of the sound. The actualization and the technicalities of a sound. Okay, wala siya ga focus on where to place our tongue by pronouncing letter K or letter C, but it deals with the technicalities to be studied. Nakuha? Nakuha ang kalahian? Yes or no? Okay, very good. Now again, these are the three branches of phonetics. Okay? We have here the key factors, no, or three sound categories of phonetics. Three sound categories of phonetics. Please take note. We have number one, the phone. Dili niyo cell phone, ha? Okay? Phone, literally, okay, means in acoustic phonetics, no? The phone here means the human sound. Okay? The phone there, basically, akong tingog yun, or imong tingog, even if you're not just pronouncing any word, any sound, or any phoneme, I mean, if you are just using your voice, maski musyagit ka diha, a-e-a-o-o lang, no? The way that you sound, human sound yun siya, literally, that's phone. Okay? That's a phone because it only talks about our human sound. Maskin tag-uron po dyan yung katapad pag matuyog, no? Muhana ka siya, Okay? And that's considered already as the phone. Again, that's phone. Okay? Please take note. And the second one is the phoneme. Phoneme, familiar? Okay, the smallest meaningful unit of a sound. Okay? The smallest meaningful unit of a sound. Familiar naman din mo sa phoneme. No? And it is the abstract meaningful unit of the sound. Meaning to say, the abstract is the theoretical, no? The abstract properties of the sound. Good. Nga nung letter K man, instead of letter C, nga parehas naman sila K pagka-pronounce, when we pronounce cat, for example, no? And nga nung dapat man yun gamitin sa letter C, and sorts of those stuffs, no? Kailangan nato siya i-consider. Why? Because it is how we understand and how we use phoneme. Sabtan? Nasabtan ko ninyo, class? Okay, very good. Are you still following? Very good. Now, we proceed sa allophones. Okay? Third category of sound sa allophones. It's basically the variations of those sounds existed in English language, no? When, for example, when we say the word magnitude, magnitude. Sige, follow daw. Magnitude. 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 The letter T there, if you notice, is pronounced as T. Yun, no? Magnitude. Yun siya. Magnitude. Magnitude. Okay? But there are other variations of the sound T there because other Americans or other English speakers, rather, pronounces as aspirated T. Okay? Or even British English, i-pronounce nila as magnitude. Okay? Therefore, ang allophone, ang systemic variation of a sound. Okay? Systemic variation of a sound. And when we try to pronounce... Maklaro pa ko diha, if daan ako dire, sa cellphone. Pakiwahing ko no gamay. John, maklaro na? How about ang sinuyat dito? Maklaro, sab? Okay. So, let's have an example, no? Allophones, when we try to pronounce the word cat, okay? Every phoneme there, balik na sa phoneme para mas masabtan, okay? Sige. Sa cat, no? Every phoneme or meaningful unit of a sound, what's the phoneme here? What's the sound of letter C? K. K. That's the sound of letter C, okay? And this word, it is pronounced as ka, 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 ka. It's not siha because you can't pronounce this as sat. Okay? It's, memorize this one. Words does not equate sound or letters or words do not equate sound, because if it does, no, the when we say letter C, C man kaha ang letter, it should be pronounced as sat, diba? But every letter or every word is different from how it sounds, diba? Sa atong word or letter nga C, in this word particularly, ma-pronounce siya as k, k. What's the phoneme again? K, k. Second phoneme? A. 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 Okay? Naapod siya ay sound nga nag-exist nga A, yun pagka-pronounce. Diba? Sa letter A, do you agree? No? Naapod siya ay pas-pas yun nga A. Diba? Naapod siya ay A, nga prolonged nga A. But the variations that I've just exemplified there are called allophones, especially sa letter A and sa letter T. Cat. Cat. The phonemes K, A, and T, when combined, mabasa siya as cat. Again, cat. K, A, T, cat siya pag-pronounce. Okay? And the varieties, ang other variants, kung si COVID sa una na ay variants, no? Ang atong sounds pod, atong phonemes pod, na siya gitawag na allophones, or as defined, pakibasa, allophones are systemic or systematic variations of sounds. Okay? As you notice, naglibog pa ba pag-pronounce sa phoneme or sa sound na A? But it depends on how it is composed, di ba? How it is applied to a word. Because cat, okay, is composed of A and E, sa letter A yun. Okay? Cat. Di siya entirely letter A, as we say abacada, no? But it is a variation of a sound of letter A that's specifically pronounced as eh, eh, eh. In American English, it is pronounced as cat. Cat. Di siya cat, okay? Pag paspasunin mo na, may mo siyang cut. Okay? Because again, a and a sound the same, but do not equate. Even if lain-lain sila ng word. Nasabtan? Okay? The same goes with sa ato sa Bisaya, no, we can actually use the letter A. The letter A, no? We can use the letter A in many different variations, di ba? Na ay pinagahay nga A, no? Kat-kat, no? Mudayag. And we can also use this in English sa pina American English na pagka-pronounce. The cat, sat, bat. Okay? Those are examples of allophones. Again, allophones. And when we say the meaningful unit or the smallest meaningful unit of a sound, on sa mana? Phoneme. Okay? That's again phonemes. Si allophones, another example, si pangayan na, are you familiar with this name? Okay, si Tim. Si Tim. Tim. Some would pronounce the letter T there as aspirated. Okay, because we have the aspirated sound, meaning na siya'y letter H, no, after the T. And the unspirated wala yun siya, letter T lang yun siya, plainly. That's why I gave you an example of the word magnitude there, because some of the speakers would pronounce the letter T there or the sound t there differently. No? Some would say na it's unspirated because some would pronounce it as magnitude, no? Wala na siya, dili siya magnitude, naapod siya magnitude nga pagka-pronounce. Okay? Magnitude means aspirated or unspirated?
Aspirated,
because there is something that is airy, no? Diha, na siya'y hangin gamay. Magnitude, no? Sa Filipino accent, in Filipino accent, guys, inganing yun siya. Magnitude. And for example, another example, international, no? International. In English, no? International or wala na iti or international, no? International. Ma-pronounce ang T differently. Okay? Inga na ang point ng allophones. Sabdan. Okay? Kuha si allophone. Yes or no? Sabdan? Or should I put more examples? More examples pa ta? Para sa sabdan? Or okay na mo? Okay na? Sure? Tagpangutom ka mo, no? You can actually communicate with me while I'm asking questions kaya para mas magkasinabot kita. Mga yes or no questions na good kaya para mas mahibaw na ako kung you're still alive there or natulog na ba mo, no? Anyway, nasabdan class? Okay, very good. Si allophones? Si phoneme? Si phone? Okay. Phone is the human sound. Review. Phoneme is the smallest meaningful unit of a sound. Allophone is the systematic or systemic variations of a sound. Nagkalain-lain na variants rather or varieties of a sound. Okay? In addition to that, I'd like to na-introduce na sa inyo ang monophthong, diphthong, triphthongs. Familiar na mo ano, no? Because I guess nga agihan na ninyo ang phonetics. No? Si monophthong, triphthongs, diphthongs, tapos na, no? You're already equipped with the vowel sounds, no? And the differences of the vowel sounds. Sige, let's have... Okay, wait for a while, no? Let's talk about phonology. This is all you need to know about phonetics. No? These are the basic considerations in learning phonetics, and let's learn phonology. But before that, let us compare the two. Okay? Let us actually contrast the two by saying that phonetics, take note, phonetics is universal. Again, phonetics is universal, therefore applicable to any languages. Okay, it is applicable to any languages. This one is universal, meaning if you have this universal charger before, no? Pwede sa siya tanan battery. Na notice ninyo sa una, if kinsay naka ano na diri ng universal charger, napalit sa Musliman, 'di ba? Keypad pa tong cellphone, no? And any battery masaksak dito. Okay? Battery sa cellphone. Okay? Now, that means to say that phonetics is universal, therefore it can be applied to any sorts or any kinds of languages. Okay? Whereas phonology is specific to language. Okay? It is specific to language, therefore, phonology is not the same as phonetics. Okay? When we try to give an example, I hope na masabtan yun ninyo. Here's the practical example why the two are different. Okay? You notice this sa atong Filipino language, no? We have this N and G nga word. Okay? Nangangailangan or ng sound, di ba? We have also an ye, no? But let's have the ng for example, no? NG, those are unique sounds of the Filipino alphabet, no? Sa atong NG nga word, for example, sa atong Bisaya, no? When we ask, we try to use this word, ngano? Ngano, di ba? In Cebuano, to be specific, we try to use this ngano sa atong language because sa atong language, in our language, this sound exists. No? It does exist sa language because we can also say sa English language, ang long, song, and so on and so forth. No? So, nag-exist po sa English language si NG, no? Or pronounced as the sound ng, but used rarely. No? Especially, di siya nag-exist as used in the beginning. It only exists, ang phonology exists on a specific language, therefore, it only deals specific to language there, no? Para mas masabta na to, sige, balik ta dere. Sa ngano nga word, okay? Sa ngano nga word in Bisaya, and we have this, Africans have this word, Ngozi. Ngozi, okay? Or Ngozi, okay? Masabtan dili. Dili, no? Because it's their word, of course, di ka-African. Kasi African dili. African, wala. Okay, so, if you're not African, it's impossible for you to understand this word. But we are getting the examples of other languages para masabtan ninyo si phonology. Okay? Now, Ngozi sa Africa, no? Ngozi sa Africa, when we try to understand si phonology mangkaha, if it is, no, let's say, phonology is universal. Let's say, ha? Let's assume nga si phonology is universal. Let's just assume. If phonology is universal, therefore, it is applicable to all languages, di ba? It is applicable to all languages. Sige, sa phonology, naatay ng nga word, or ng. Let's try to use ng because ng still exists in English. Applicable man ka sa tanan language, di ba? Applicable sa Bisaya, sa African. Let's try sa English. Give me an English word, any English word. So, wala mo nibala an English word? Language? Ah, language. Since language an example, nag-una ba si NG? We try to experiment. Paunahan na to si NG, no? Mabasa dili. Mabasa siya, pero it's not existing. Language. Okay? Therefore, as you can notice, phonology can never be universal. Okay? It will never be, according to linguistics. Sabtan. But sa phonetics, how words are pronounced and how tongues are placed, no? When we say, sa Bisaya, it's still the same, no? When we pronounce, sa Ngozi, sa Africa. Because our tongue is still placed the same. Nga sa ngalangala na imong dila panindi. Di ba na sa ngalangala? When you try to pronounce, try. Ngano. Ngano. Sige, inirakan. Ang sound nag-agi sa nasal. Di ba? Panindi na hangin sa imong ilong. If walay hangin nga mugawas sa imong ilong, go to the nearest hospital and have yourself checked up. Di ba naasa nasal? Agree? Okay, naasa nasal. How about sa African? Ngozi. It's still the same placement, di ba? How about sa asa naman to? Language. Oh. It's still the same. Phonetics, therefore, is applicable to any language and phonology is specific to language. P because each phonological language has different characteristics or system. Kuha. Lain-lain ang sistema ng language na to. Diba? We pronounce NG differently and we use in NG differently. We use ng sound differently and we use the ng sound uniquely. According sa atong unique characteristics of language. Unique usage of language and the unique sound of language. That's why phonology is specific to language. Questions? None? Sabtan? Okay? Di pwede mag-language, ha? Di pwede mag-language. Because it does not exist in English, just means to say nga phonetics lang yun ang universal. Okay? Kuha? Okay, hasa naman to. Sige. Let's have the, ano, phonological key terms or another concepts sa phonology. Okay? Payano na ako ni? Can I erase this one, ha? Tapos naman nag-copy? Okay. Iman na isingan nyo, ha? Nga no, ngodzi, sunan si language. Okay? Sige, sa atong final topics, no? We still have time. Key terms in philosophy na noon? Phonology. Key terms here. First, we have the blend. Okay? Familiar mo sa blender? Familiar mo? Yes or no?
Yes.
Blender? Naamoy blender?
Yes.
Or at least nakakita mo blender? Okay? Sa blender, it is used to combine things, of course, to mix things, no? One, two, or more things. Diba? That's the ano, nature of blending something, no? Blending things, for example. Now, in phonology, of course, in language, blending also, or blending, or blend also exists. And one example of this, let's define it first, okay? It's the two or more consonants or two or more sounds combined. Again, two or more sounds combined. Meaning to say, two or more consonants combined. The blend here, for example, is the word bring. The first letter or the first sound, sige, ano naman dyan? Okay, grade 1 kalabasa. What is this? Uy, unsa man ni?
Bring.
Ang gi-underline na?
Bring.
B. Or it sounds as? B. B. Again, letters and sounds do not correlate. Okay? B. Or sounds as B. 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 Ball. Brought. Bring. And another letter here? Another sound? Sound. R. Very good. R. Again. Again. Good dog. Nagkalain-lain nga sound. Take note, ha? Different sounds. And lain pod ang ilang consonants. Of course, it's called blend. When we pronounce the sound b, b, and lain naman pod ang r, lain-lain sila nga characteristic or lain-lain sila nga sound. These sounds are different from one another or from each other, rather, no? These sounds are different from each other and it is combined in one word. We call that blend. Kuha si blend. Another example, sige, brother, no? Or the word blend, good, no? Sa word nga blend, ma-pronounce ang B dili. Ma-pronounce dili. Ma-pronounce, of course. That's letter B. Or the sound? B. Again, the sound? B. Again, the sound? L. Ma-pronounce ba? Pag magbasa kita ng blend, ma-pronounce ba ang letter L?
Yes.
Yes, of course, ma-pronounce ang letter L. Ayaw sa mo pag-focus diri ha. Don't focus here yet. Focus first on the first one that I want you to focus. Letter B or pronounced as the sound as B. Next sound. L. Lain-lain sila na sound parehas. Lain-lain. Pag lain-lain, imo pag-mix, blend. Sabtan. Another key term. It is called as the digraph. Okay? Digraph is somehow similar, nag-blend gihapon ka, pero it results to one sound. Okay? Two different or two or more different consonants, no? Line-line sila nga consonants, but results into one sound. For example, the word shop. Sige, let's focus first here. Letter S, pronounce daw. Letter H, i-pronounce daw. Shunish. Ya pagani, ang H pagana ko tagpangutana. Sige, ito dahi ang H. Shunish. Ayaw sana i-combine. Okay, ayaw sana i-combine. Letter S, what's the sound of letter S? What's the sound of letter H? Ano yun, ha? Okay? Ha? Ayaw lang ito dahi, kaya basig mag-face mask na imong katapad. Letter H, no? It's pronounced as... But when we try to combine the two, mabasa ba sila as two different sounds? Ano yun, yes? Two different sounds ba? Pag i-combine ang two, i-combine ang two. One sound or two sounds? One sound. That's what we call digraph. Sabtan. Sabtan si digraph. Again, si blend. Two consonants or two or more consonants, but each consonant there is pronounced. Each sound is articulated. Okay? Whereas a digraph, lain-lain lang yung mga consonant, no? Two consonants, but pronounced when combined, pronounced as one sound. Okay? Again, basa ha, si shop, no, ang SH, duha man nga dyan ka consonants, consonant si letter S, dili. Consonant, dili. Consonant. Di na mo kinain ang vowel sa ng consonants? Consonant, dili.
Consonant.
Letter H, consonant?
Consonant.
Pag i-combine, digraph. Duha bang gyapon ini ka consonant? For example, it's still the same. Consonant si B dili.
Consonant
si R dili. But if you pronounce it together, lain-lain na sound. That's what we call blend. Okay, di man ka pwede mag brr, brr. Ma-pronounce mag yun na nimo sila. Brr, b and r. Di man siya one sound. Lain-lain mo siya ng mga sounds. Sabtan. Okay, very good. Now, let's move forward to the third key term. Dissibilant or the hissing sound, ladies and gentlemen, when you pronounce the letter S or letter Z, that's called as the hissing sound. As long as nice, it's either letter S, no, or letter Z. Those kinds of sounds, no, are called sibilant sounds. Okay? The sibilant sounds. Always remember that when you use sibilant sounds, you're referring to letters S and letter Z. Okay? Again, pag naay, for example, sa words, for example, sige, let's have this, word nga miss, for example, no, miss. The last two consonant letters there are sounded as one, and therefore it is a sibilant sound. Sa miss ba? Miss. Diba? Ang last sounds considered as sibilant sound. or hissing sounds because naa siya mo sa hayas ba? Okay? Amo ka sa imo friend, no? Kung imo friend hilig ng sibilant sound, delikado. Okay? Kay pag sibilant sound, when we say sibilant sound, it is referring to the hissing sound or the sound. Diba? That's sibilant sound. Again, that's sibilant sound. Nasabtan. Okay. We have, again, another concept. Last one. Last one for this evening, no? We have the so-called phonological conditioning. In phonological conditioning, when we try to, number one, see sibilant sound, this is nag-end siya sa S, a Z, sa letter as number 2, voiceless . Are you familiar with the voiced and voiceless na, no? What are the sounds that are voiced and what are the voiceless? Familiar? Uy, familiar ba? Nagiana ninyo? Again, sort of review lang ha. When we say a voiced sound, any sound that has vibrations. Okay? The words L, L, i-pronounce ang L, 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 L. Sabay ko. L. L. Na vibration wala. Therefore it is voice. But when you try to pronounce letter S, for example, what's the sound of letter S? Therefore it is voiceless. Okay? The voiceless. Hindi ko makita. Okay, John, makita na. The voiceless. Asa naman to? Sa voice, take note sa phonological conditioning, this applies for pluralization. Again, this applies to pluralization or for pluralization. When we try to pluralize some words or when we try to pluralize a word, no? Maano siya? Mabilong siya sa phonological conditioning and we can use this to communicate effectively and to construct effectively, no, sa atong mga words, especially in English language. Now, class, maminaw, give me an example of a word that ends with a sibilant sound. Aside sa miss, kagayina. His, yung ma-pluralize po na, ayaw po nang dili ma-pluralize. His. T-I-S-S. D-I-S-S. Okay, that's a bit, ano. Let's have another example. Freeze. Freeze. Let's have freeze. Kinsa mo itong ingon ng freeze? Freeze. Sige. Sa sibilant sound, if nag-end daw siya sa sibilant sound, it should have or mag-add dapat ka mag-pluralize man ka sa freeze, for example. Okay? Please read. Freeze. O may last na sound. Sound, ha? Zzz. If you pluralize the word freeze, you add zzz. Ang zzz ba na sound? Voiced or voiceless? Voiced nga sibilant. Okay? Therefore, pag voiced nga sibilant, ang i-add zebra yun. That's the confusing part. Okay? Because if we try to analyze, no? The sibilant here, freeze. Dapat ang i-add e dili pwede freezes. Okay? Dili pwede freezes. Because sibilant ka nag-end sa z, for example, dapat es ang mag-pluralize na ka. If mag-pluralize na ka. Okay? Di siya pwede freezes. It should be freezes. Okay? Nasabtan. Sa voiceless. Sige, paghatag mo voiceless. Let's say, any word nga nag-end sa voiceless nga sound. Cat. Let's say cat. No? Ang letter T, voiceless man na. Is there any vibration? Wala, di ba? Wala. So, the word cat there, no? Pag mag-add ka ng pluralization or another factor para ma-pluralize, it should be S. That's the phonological conditioning. Di ka pwede mag-cads. Di ka pwede mag-letter Z. No? Na pwede. Because a voiceless, according sa rule, ang voiceless, dapat ang mag-follow if mag-pluralize ka, mag-fall siya into letter or sound as S or S na letter. Okay? Sa voice, nasabtan si voiceless. Yes or no? Okay, very good. Sa atong voice, pod, sa voice, let's proceed now sa voice. If the kuan daw, if the letter or the sound or the word ends with a voiceless sound, let's have an example. Any example? Sige, dog. Dog na sab. G, g. Voiced or voiceless? Again, voiced or voiceless? Voiced. Kaya na ay vibration. Okay? There is a vibration, therefore it is voiced. Pag voiced daw, class, mag-add na pod ka og letter. Sa dog man to, no? Dog. Mag-add na pod ka og letter. S. Dogs. Dogs. It's not dogs. Okay? It's not word. Again, example. Word, letter, the word bill, for example, no? Bill, voiceless. Last word or last sound. Voice, di ba? Voice, therefore, ang i-add? S, bills. Pag mag-pluralize. This only applies, again, take note ha, utangi for pluralization. When you pluralize something. Pag voice, ang i-add letter S. Pag voiceless, ang i-add letter S gihapon. Masses. Okay? Di na pwede mag-masses. Di na pwede. Okay? That's a mortal sin according to the rule. Okay? Sibilant sound, may i-add? ES. Okay? By the way, ang sh nga sound sa shop nga example nato, mabilong siya sa sibilant sound. Because there is still a hissing sound. Shh, 'di ba? Na siya ay hissing sound. It's not only S, it's not only Z, but therefore it is also considered as shh. Mabilong siya sa again, sibilant. Sabtan. Any confusions? None so far. Questions? All these things na akong tagsulti, no? They must be mastered by you because you are English language majors and you will use these types of technicalities for communication. Okay? These are the standards, and you must follow these standards for you to achieve the standards, of course. And let us change the culture of the AB students, especially the English language students. We should communicate effectively because to articulate out there is one of the most precious skills that you can have. Okay? Value communication because it will benefit in the long run. Kasi nabot? Okay? Now, you have to study this rigorously and religiously so that you will be an effective communicator and articulator. Okay? Para mas masabtan ninyo ang English language. Sinabot? Questions? Wala na? Ikaw ulit mo? Nakapamoy klase, wala na? Okay. Alas 8 na, and then I guess this will wrap us onto the on our first lesson. Did you learn something tonight? Okay, that's good to know. Let's see each other next meeting. Okay, goodbye everyone. Paki payong ako palihog. Paki stop.